For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The love of God shed abroad on the gospel that Jesus Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and was buried, and arose again the third day according to the scriptures. That if you were to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that it would be saved from the pit of hell. God's love for you by Jesus Christ has said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You're not going to go to heaven with your religion. You will not go to heaven on good wishes. You will not go to heaven by what you think are good works. The only possible means to get to heaven is by the Lord Jesus Christ, through the Lord Jesus Christ, of the Lord Jesus Christ, that is the Son of God. Any other ways that you may come with upon your brain of access to God the Father, if it's not of the biblical way through Jesus Christ, you will be tormented by your belief in anything else but the Lord Jesus Christ. Now notice how we have the police department. All through Daytona Beach, you can't find the police, but when a man gets up and starts preaching, there they are. For God so loved. Everybody wants that lovely, godly message that God is love. And the Bible does say that God is love. And yet the Bible also says that our God is holy. And God says within the pages of the Bible, be ye holy, for I am holy. And the American way is complete opposite of holiness. It's unholiness that a country, that a world will think that God will allow them in their sin into a place called heaven, the heavenly bound, the holy bound of God the Father. You see, heaven is a holy place. The world is a cesspool. God is the reign of heaven. And Satan is the reign of this world. And you cannot approach God in worldly ways. You don't get to heaven by getting a Tootsie Roll for saying a prayer. You don't get to heaven just by a prayer. You get to heaven by with your heart belief that your sin, your actions, your thoughts, your conduct is unbecoming of God and opposite of holiness, that you offend God, the holy God, with what you are doing in your life. And when you come to the acknowledgement of what you are doing that offends God, that you repent of your sins and get right, as we see another cop car coming. Repenting of your sins is not glorifying your sins. Repenting of your sins is saying, God, I am sorry and I want to stop. And if I cannot stop, I am going to give all effort by prayer and by grace that you will help me get the victory over this sin. But if and when I do sin, I am sorry for my sin. Repentance is coming to God and you want to get right and do right. And coming to God that there's no other way to get right. There's no other way to Now, I had right here in my heart another message today, but it's so windy I can't do it. It'll give me another week of prayer and working. But you've got to realize that we stand here and tell you that death is coming. I am 100% prophecy on the fact is you will die. The wages of sin is death. And I am definitely speaking to people who are sinners. And being sinners, you will die. And whatever you think about death, whatever you think happens after death, if it's not from the biblical stance, you are wrong. If it's not been inspired by the Holy Spirit of the King James 1611 Bible, you will be surprised when you die. And we stand here trying to unsurprise you. And the one very fact is the unsurprise is, if you were to die and end up in hell now, you would be unsurprised because you hear the preaching of hell. And you hear that the gospel that Jesus Christ died for your sins, according to the scripture, Jesus Christ was buried. And he arose again the third day according to the scriptures, that he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You have heard the means on how to get out of hell. So if you were to die and end up in hell, there will be no surprise. You would say that preacher in the Bible is correct. And you'll stand before God at the judgment seat and proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord and be cast off in the lake of fire that burns forever. And the word that's been preached to you will be, amen, he's right. But we don't want you to go to hell. Now, someone may tell you to go to hell, but you don't even realize the consequences of those words. We preach Jesus. Jesus saves from hell. There are Christians out there, I don't preach hell. What else is there? Because without Jesus Christ as your faith and belief in your heart, you will go to hell. But if you were to believe upon your heart, if you were to put your faith on the finished work that Jesus has done, you can become a born-again, Bible-believing Christian and be saved and have your name written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. What's it mean to have you let your name in the Lamb's Book of Life mean to be endorsed by the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world? And I know you can hear me. I have settled that account a long time ago by you. I know you can hear the words. And I know you have cussed in your ears to say, block that out. But imagine God taking you and blocking you out of the Book of Life. Because you will not hear. And yet the Bible also says they have ears that they hear not. You're as dumb as a statue. Now listen to me, I'm not talking about dumb as stupid, idiot, and all that. I'm talking as dumb as you will not open your mouth to confess your sins to Jesus. In the Bible, dumb means you can't speak. Why will you not confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus to be saved? Why will you not believe in your heart to be saved and to get out of hell and to go to heaven? What is preventing you from believing the way, the truth, and the life? Honk if you love Jesus. What is preventing you? 5 years you have heard the gospel preached here for the mentor. And not one of you have come out and stepped. And you may say, well, preacher, then that's a failure. You have failed, go home, pack up, don't come back. No, I have not failed. Because I have planted a seed, many seeds, upon this ground, Daytona Beach. And you don't even realize it. Now what that seed will do, if it germinates or just dies and rots in the ground, that's yours. That's your doing. But what we are doing according to the Bible is we are planting the seed of the gospel. We are telling you the field of the world that you must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. Now some people will go into a panic. OMG, there are plastic bags floating away. They're going to go in the water. The sea turtles are going to get caught in the plastic bag. The whales will eat those plastic bags. They're going to die. Save the whales. And yet your soul, when it dies, unless it's saved, will burn in eternity where no animal will go. Animals, when they die, go back to the earth. The Bible proclaims. They do not have a living soul. When Bambi dies, they will die in the ground. That's it. No heaven, no hell for any animal. And you can save 10,000 whales, and yet if your own soul is not washed in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, see, you got the wrong animal. You need the Lamb of God which takes away the sin of the world. Now you do not save that lamb. That lamb saves you. You would think that Satan gets it all messed up. Let's look at whales, let's look at turtles, but let's not look at the lamb. And if I were to look at that lamb, I guess he would need to be saving too, and that's all wrong. That's contrary to the gospel. The lamb died for you. The lamb shed its blood. The lamb of God which take away your sin. That's what you need to do. Animals never sin as much as you've sinned. And you will be held accountable to your sins under God unless you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and get your sins washed away. Pure. Come, let us reason together, the Bible says in 1:18. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. There's no other means. There's no other salvation. The salvation right now that rests upon your heart. I'm not even preaching to the people. I'm preaching to you that's listening right now. Your heart will stand condemned before God unless you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved. I've got to know. You've got to have the Lamb. I do this. You've got to do what the Lamb done. It's all on the merit of Jesus Christ. You, nothing. There's nothing you can do. Not of works, please, any man boast. God sent His Son into the world that you may have eternal life, and all that rests upon the Son and nothing else. It's not by water, it's by the blood of Jesus Christ that cleanses us from all sin, that makes us righteous. Even upon salvation, that I am saved, I am washed in the blood of God, the Holy Spirit has made me a child of God, I have no righteousness of myself but that of Jesus Christ. And even if I were to sin as a Christian, there's no righteousness. The righteousness rests upon God, rests upon Jesus Christ. I'm good, you may think. You're not gooder than Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the goodest. nothing you can do. There's nothing that you can think that outpowers God and what he has done. And listen, if you do think, okay, I can do it without Jesus Christ, it will be weighed by Jesus Christ, and you'll be found wanting. You can pay for your sins in hell, where Jesus Christ has paid for your sins. You can have your sins be cleansed by hellfire. But the problem with that hellfire is for you, it takes eternal. It's forever. There's no payment that can ever be fixed in hell. You just must continue to pay for your sins in the fire. There's no rest in hell. There's no peace in hell. There's no party in hell. You will pay for your sins that you could lay upon the Lamb of God today. You can settle the account today. And when the count is settled with God, it will never be seen again. When you put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ as your Savior, your sins are washed, they are clean, they are no more to be remembered by God. You see, baptism, God sees your sins. They haven't been washed. You see, Mary can't do nothing. Allah is a small G-O-D-S. Atheism don't work because God is still there. Evolution is impossible to fulfill. Show me God. Look around. Job says, look at the animals. Study the animals. Look at the ants. The ant will tell you that there is a God. Death will come. And it may, now this is what I don't know, it may come this afternoon, it may come this morning, it may come today for you. And when you wake up in the eternal life, whether heaven or whether hell, you cannot come back and redo or undo what you've done. That moment you wake up in hell, you cannot come back and say, well, I believe on Jesus now. And when you gladfully enter to the gates and be with the Lord, and you have not done enough for the Lord, you can't come back and say, oh, Lord, I'll go and do what you want me to do. That's too late. Yes, it's too late. When you are cast into hell, that's the wrong time to say, oh my God, there is a hell. I don't think you would say God, though. Oh, M, there's a hell. And believe it or not, friends, when you stand before the great white throne judgment, you're going to have to profess that Jesus Christ is Lord. No matter what you think or what you believe, that moment, when the realization that the preaching is true, and you've got to humble yourself on your knees and say, God, you are the God that I heard about, that I rejected. Oh, Lord God, show me mercy. Too late. Oh, Lord God, give me grace. Too late. Now, God may give us tomorrow. He may give you tomorrow. And you're not even thankful. You may hear the message today and God give you a week, a month, a year. And you're not even thankful. And you say, preacher, where's that judgment? Where is that time you preach about? And I say, God's long-suffering, he's not willing that any should perish, and he's giving you one more day, one more Saturday to hear that gospel. He's giving you one more Saturday to repent and get right by Jesus Christ, because you may die tonight. You may die this afternoon. I can imagine the worst thing to be to have death happen right here at the farmer's market while the preach is going on and wake up in hell. And that soul that will drop off in hell be like, come on people, believe him, he's right. Now you're going to find out one day, to God's glory, or to your damnation, you're going to realize one day that that Bible right there is right. You're going to realize that there is a holy God, and he will not permit sin to reign. He will not let religion come in. And that moment when you realize that the Bible is correct and you have been calling it a foul all your life, it's too late. Why are we here week after week? Because we want to get you before it's too late. For some of you, you've heard this over and over and over. Some of you are brand new. You're like, what is that moron doing? What on earth is he screaming about? He's screaming about Jesus saying. There's no other way to God but Jesus Christ. And we are here because we know you're going to die, but I don't know when you're going to die, and I don't want you in hell. And I say, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Before you die. Listen, people, I cannot ever street preach in a cemetery. It won't work. And if there's a funeral, it's perverted, it's wrong. You don't do that. But I can't preach to people who have already died. It'd be useless and no effect. I cannot say to a graveyard, all right, anybody here, come on out and let's believe on Jesus and go. And once your body is buried or burned to ashes, whatever you decide to do, you have an afterlife. Though that body be in a casket or be inside of a yard, your soul lives forever. And if you die without Jesus Christ, there is no rest in peace. There is no peace, save the Lord unto the wicked, Ezekiel. In Isaiah. A man that dies without Jesus Christ has no R.I.P. because he will not believe the KJV. Every grave that has a person that has rejected Jesus Christ, write the word loser. When you die without Jesus Christ, you're a loser. You lost. Here lies loser. Died without Christ. Scientology, evolution, religion, science, public, whatever it is, that dies as a loser into the pits of hell. You know what's worse about hell, people? Over heaven? Satan's not even there yet. He will be there. sin doesn't go to hell to Revelation 20. So you will die and go to hell where your God is not. Now the Bible says about a Christian that goes to heaven absent from the body and present with the Lord, when I die and go to heaven, there's Jesus. Satan doesn't even have enough gold to show up where you go for him. So when you die without Jesus Christ, you don't have your God until later on. But when you die in Jesus Christ, there he is to welcome you. Praise the Lord. And when death comes upon a Christian, when that death comes upon your eyelids, you close your eyelids, and then you open them again, there is the Lord Jesus Christ that suffered and died and buried for you. And arose from the grave. According to the scriptures, there he is. The Bible says that Jesus will never leave you if you're saved. How do you know he's with you when you die? Because if he's absent from the body, and there he is with you. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Now, granted, I'll be afraid of the way to die. I am not ashamed to admit I hate pain. I would hope that my death is quietly, quickly, silently, without pain. But no matter the means of death, absent from the body and present with the Lord, because I have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ and I am saved. Not so is a man in hell. Oh, loser dies. He wakes up in torment and never comes out. Oh, if I could just have a drop of water. Just a drop of water. Just a drop. My tongue. And in hell, the Bible says you have eyes, you have a tongue, you have a desire. All eternity. And you say, oh, he's ruined business. I wish that guy would shut up. Get out of here with Jesus. What are you going to think in hell for all eternity? That guy was right. The Bible's right. I'm in trouble. I'm in torment. Torment. You know what torment means? You're going to thirst for alcohol and there's no alcohol. You're going to want a boogie-woogie. There's no dancing. There's no party. Oh, God, the pain! There's no relief. It's a disease that's eating away your body but does not consume the body. It is causing pain and sorrow. There's no relief. And there's no time. And there's no way to get out. And yet, if you were to be saved and get your sins washed under the blood of the Lamb, the Bible says a new body. Isn't that good enough that the Bible's correct? Isn't that good enough to get a new body? Body by God. Perfect, sinless. It's not going to stink. It will not need deodorant. It will not ever need to be showered. It will not need soap. It's a clean, holy body for all eternity, opposite of a body that's in hell. It's a body that will not ever get diseased. It's a body that will never, ever get cancer. It's a body that will never suffer pain or rejection once you get to the eternal life. Once you pass through the gates of heaven, you have with the Lord Jesus Christ, that body will have no more pain and sorrow. Now, do not believe that if you get saved right now on this earth, there's pain and sorrow on this earth. I am not saying believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and your life will be wonderful living on this earth. But when you get to the eternal life, when death has come, you have passed on. The Bible says all tears will be wiped away, Revelation 21. Have you shed tears? Are you suffering? Is your life in misery? Is your doctor, your pharmacist, curing everything of your body today? Many of you, the doctor is your savior. Not when you die. And by the way, when you die, your doctor fails. Don't wait for science to give you eternal life. They never will. They're lying to you. Science is the same one that said we came from monkeys. Science is the same one that said, oh, there's life on Mars. Science cannot preach what Jesus preached. Come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. There are two bodies in glory. There are two bodies in the afterlife. There's a body that will get tormented forever, no more time. And there's a body that will be praised, will be honored, will be glorified in Jesus Christ. And then we got these miserable bodies we're carrying around right now. Salvation will not end the age process. You will get older, you will get painful. You will smell like peppermint. And your children remember that. I don't know why grandma smelled like peppermint. And then you get old and you figure, oh, now I know why. Listen, I'm a saved, born-again, Bible-believing Christian. I hate it. I sin. I'm not happy. I confess my sin. I am washed in the blood of God. My body's breaking down. Evolution's a lie. I'm old, but forgive me for not knowing your words today. If you were to visit an old folks' home as an evolutionist, you will see that evolution's a lie in old folks' homes. I don't know what you call them today. That's what we called them when I grew up. There are people breaking down. There are people dying in old folks' homes. That defies evolution. So let's turn to God. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. You need a remedy. That remedy is the Lord, is the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world. Life is not getting better. Life is not getting better. If life was better and under evolution, you would not see medicine on the television for men to get muscular and husky and other things I can't mention. The fact is that you gotta get up at 3 o'clock in the morning to go pee shows you ain't getting better. So evolution's not helping you. It's destroying you. And yet when I say believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved, that will uplift you. That's a benefit to you. That is getting yourself out of hell, getting a new body, having no more problems and troubles when you die or rapture. Again, let me put the clause here. I'm not talking about wonderful, great life, believing on Jesus right now. That comes after death. Well, whoopee. I mean, I want something that makes me feel good now. Go pay $19.95 with shipping and handling. And find out it don't work. Alright? Vote for that Democratic president. Find out you're going to have 4 more years of crap. Alright? Your Trump has done nothing for this nation. Your Obama has done nothing for this nation. This nation still rejects God and rejects the Bible and Jesus Christ. But God bless America. No, he won't. not without Jesus Christ. There'll be no blessing of America until Jesus Christ is allowed. And America don't want Jesus Christ. Oh, they want him when they got a cuss and they bruise their finger up. Then they call Jesus. If there's no hell, why do you say go to hell?
Listen to me now.
If there's no God, why don't you say, Allah damn it? Come on, people. Why do you use God's name with damn? And yet the Bible says any man that takes his Lord's name in vain, he'll suffer. And vain doesn't mean just cussing God's name. It's just using the Lord's name, using the Lord's name. Jesus, sweet Jesus, not Jesus. That's vain. When you're not calling on him for worship, or you're not calling him on praise, you're not calling on him for absolute. You can't just go, Jesus, Jesus, God, 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 God. That's vain. And the Bible says, thou shalt not use the name of the Lord in vain. Read and study your Bible, people. You're a Bible-ignorant nation. Oh, everyone must pledge allegiance to the flag and skip the Bible. I laugh if you find out one day some of those players were actually kneeling and praying to God while they were doing that. If any one of those players gets down knees to God in prayer during that time, God loves it. God loves someone that prays. And I'd love to see you come out now and pray and say, God, I'm a sinner. I am repenting. I want to get right by Jesus Christ. That'd be a prayer that knocked me down.
Stars of Japan. Flag, Bible.
Think about it. You're going to die. What's going to happen? No, that's not true. You say you don't know what I thought or said. I know what you thought or said. I've been there. And if it's not Jesus Christ, when I just asked you to think about after death, if it's not Jesus Christ, it's not going to work out for the good. Listen, before I was saved, I had a fear to casket because I thought you were still alive. That passes all belief of breathing, but that's what I believe. I thought you were still alive and conscious in that grave. But up from the grave he arose, victorious. And now I have no more fear over death and hell, because I have been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, which cleanses us from all sin. What's your victory? You got a big fat guy with a belly button sticking out, sitting down, that's dead, and for everyone to see. You can't see my Jesus until he calls you home. Elephant, your God? That's just peanuts. God of all gods, King of kings, Lord of lords, Jesus Christ. Your God will bow down before my God. And I will witness that day around that throne. You know, listen to me. I want to see you at judgment seat. I am here to watch you get judged. At the judgment seat of Christ, I'd love to see you get saved and stand before Jesus. Because those that are at the judgment seat of Christ, their fate after death has been sealed by the blood of Jesus Christ. I do not want to see you at the great white throne judgment. Because at the great white throne judgment, you will be condemned, you will be damned, and cast in the lake of fire that burns forever. I am here to get you at the judgment seat of Christ and get you away from the great white throne judgment. That's why I'm here. I'm here that when you die, you will open your eyes to Jesus Christ and not open your eyes in torment. if you were to believe on Jesus Christ. But the Bible says, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. That I have been faithful to. Now, what happens to you now after is something I cannot do. You've got to reject or you've got to believe. I can't do nothing for you. The choice is yours. You can say yes to Jesus, or you can say no to Jesus. I advise you to take yes, Jesus. I advise you to put your stock in Jesus
about the eternal life.
Why we're here every week. It's why we pray for you. But if you were to reject Jesus, you're without excuse. You can never tell God, I never knew. But imagine God saying, I never knew you. But God, it's not good enough if it's not Jesus. Put your idols and your religion in the garbage can and come out with Jesus Christ, will ya? The American flag will not save your soul, the Bible will. You must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved, and yet God has given you the choice. Death is coming, you just don't know when. There are people dying right now. Some may go to heaven. The few, the Bible says, most will go into hell. You may get word this afternoon a loved one has passed on. Death is so close and yet it will come knocking on your door. And before death comes, you need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to go to heaven. And if death comes and you have not, you will burn in hell. You will suffer torment by not believing on Jesus Christ. You are not safe without Jesus Christ. No way, no how, according to the Bible. Everything I said today about Jesus is according to the Bible. The Word of God. And if you reject the Word of God, you will be damned. You will be judged. And you will be found wanting. And you will proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord. You will confess Jesus Christ is Lord, while Jesus will confess to you, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. That simple.